Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Plants vs. Zombies. Last time, we continued working our way through some mini-games, and this time we're gonna be continuing to do that. And we're gonna save the Zen Garden for the end, because we know that all we have in there right now is marigolds. Here we go. We're starting with Begooled Twist. We did Begooled a couple episodes back, and I was awful at it. What's Begooled Twist? I don't know. Click to twist plants. Oh my god. Okay. So like that. So I guess I can technically just kind of mash buttons all over the place. This is gonna work considerably better actually, because I don't even have to try. I can just do this. Yeah, okay. I don't even care. I don't even care if I'm kind of cheesing it by doing this. But this is considerably faster than considerably faster than regular Begooled, let me tell you. There was one right there. Now, Sid, I know you're watching this. My good boy Eerie, I know you are watching this video right now. And Sid called me out for just how bad I was at the regular Begooled. Don't judge me. Please don't judge me for what I'm currently doing. Literally all we have to do to win is get matches. Like, it's not a case of, there we go. It's not a case of, like, defeating a certain amount of zombies or anything like that. It's just get matches. But we can potentially get the repeaters this time. We didn't get the repeaters last time we did Begooled, so that'd be kind of nice. This is so much easier, though. Just getting to spam it. Like this just works. Here we go. Repeaters. There we go. And then we can just keep building up our sun again, because of course sun doesn't really matter. It's not our goal right here. Huge wave approaches. Okay, there's gotta be something up here. There we go. Generally, it's the top one. Oh, no possible moves. Okay. Let me shuffle then real quick. I'm gonna start from the bottom, because if we start from the bottom, we can potentially, get some combo moves going, you know? Potentially. Potench. Alright, we're at 41 out of 75 matches. I feel like we're doing 20 times better than we did before. And that's just because I'm spamming the button over and over again. So, you know. It's hurting my wrist, though. I'm not gonna lie. Let's get Tall Nuts out. I'm not even gonna lie. It's starting to hurt my wrist a little bit, moving my mouse around and just spamming the button. No possible moves again. Shuffle. It just keeps happening, huh? I mean, I guess we're speeding through these, so it kind of makes sense that that's happening. And I know what you're possibly thinking.
Thomas, this isn't actually that hard of a game mode, and you should just be playing it normally so that you get better at it. You know, you get better at Begooled.
Trust me, I'm never playing Bejeweled or Begooled again after this. there's gonna be like something in the future where I'm playing Bejeweled again and I get quoted from this video. I just know it. But hey, it's okay. We almost got the fume shrooms. I think a couple more bits of sun, or like one more bit of sun. Fume shrooms! Fully upgraded everything. Not bad. We're at 61 out of 75 matches. It's literally just an endurance test at this point. Just spam that button. And, just spam the mouse button and get the matches, basically. That's all we gotta do. Keep spamming. I clicked out of the game. I was wondering when that was gonna happen. I figured I would click out of the game at some point, given how much mashing I'm doing right here. There's another one. No possible moves. Shuffle away. Okay, okay. Keep spamming. Keep spamming. Just spam that mouse button. There we go. We only need two more. Oh no! Let me immediately replenish that. Bro, where is this next move? There it is. I was gonna say, what the heck? There we go. I mean, we only lost one plant, so I'll take that. Go ahead and shuffle, why not? Well, that took considerably less time than the first one, than regular Bejeweled. I gotta tell you. Big Trouble Little Zombie is up next, so we're potentially taking on three minigames in this episode. Yeah, those are some little zombies. And we don't get to choose, we just have the conveyor belt, okay. Oh, I like this music! I really like this music. Oh, you're appearing quickly, huh? Okay, cherry bomb. I'm gonna wait just to see what we get. I'm like dancing along with the music right now. Actually, wait, haven't we done a wasn't there a mode like this in the regular, like in story mode? I feel like there was. I feel like that we did a mini game like this previously. This guy's moving hella quick. Alright, let me just drop a bomb right here. Drop a bomb right here. There we go. Get some walnut. I didn't mean to replenish him. I meant to put it above him. Whoops. I'm just gonna cherry bomb this big group up here. And cherry bomb. Oh, hello. Get rid of that guy. And then walnut. There we go. Hello. Oh, you guys are coming into the water now. That's just fantastic. Just fantastic and not at all what I want to be dealing with. Let me cherry bomb this group. Cherry bomb. No, I don't need to cherry bomb him. I think we'll be good here with the pea shooter out. I'd like some more lily pads so that we can get some walnuts going over here. A good amount of cherry bombs coming in, so we can just keep abusing those for the time being. Let's get a pea shooter in the middle. And then you guys, I guess I'm just gonna wait there. Lily pad and walnut. I think we're stalling out the wave. I know I've said numerous times, like, oh, I think we're stalling out the wave, and then we're not stalling out the wave. I feel like this time we actually are stalling out the wave. But I'm gonna do this anyway. Let's get moving. Huge wave approaches. Okay, we got 3 cherry bombs on deck. I'm waiting for another walnut. 4 cherry bombs on deck. Alright, we are about to abuse the hell out of these things. Come on, I want another walnut. God damn it. Well, let me just do that. Get another pea shooter up here. You're eating that walnut. That's fine. And put these down here. Walnut, there we go. I don't like that you're eating him. Boom. And there we go. We have offense on every single row now. Boom. I'm just gonna blow everybody up here. Oh, we got the freaking swimmers coming in. That's fine, that's fine. We'll be okay. Let's get a second column of these guys going. Could you stop? Could you quit doing that? I'm gonna blow you up. That's just how it's gonna go. I'm just gonna blow you up. We really gotta just utilize cherry bombs in this. They're your best friend. Simple as that. They are your best friend. You're pretty weak. Yeah, no. Get rid of everybody right now. Oh, we got that guy coming in. God damn it. There's so many zombies. I know they're tiny, but like there's so many of them. That's the issue here. Drop that. Drop that. I'm gonna start doing a second column of walnuts. Instead of replenishing these guys, I'm just gonna start doing a second column of them. Because it's gonna take a little while for them to break through. Alright, what do you got, second wave? Second heavy wave? Alright, got our all-star zombies up there. Just the one so far, got a lot of cone heads. Okay, we got a couple all-stars up there, so let's drop that and drop that. And that's basically the first set of that wave done, my god. I'm gonna do that. Boom. Let's get another couple of lily pads out over here. Walnut. Pea shooter right there. Okay, we're looking pretty good right now, I would say. I'd like another cherry bomb, though. I kind of used a lot of them there. I just need one. Please. One cherry bomb. Oh, he broke through the walnut down here. There we go. Boom! Got some chocolate for Stinky. Okay, and then let's drop... Oh, you broke through my other walnut. Oh my god. They're, like, strong. I feel like these guys have the same power as the regular-sized zombies. Is that just me? I feel like they do. It certainly feels that way. Okay, god, there's so many of them coming through. There's so many freaking zombies coming through. I probably should have held on to more cherry bombs. Oh no. Boom! Okay, walnut up there. Just got the one guy right here. Cherry bomb on deck. Okay. And here comes the huge wave. That wasn't even technically the huge wave. I feel like we got through the huge wave, and then it's just like, oh, here's more. Okay. I'm gonna put this guy down here because we've got no defense. And then you here. And then I'm mostly gonna rely on cherry bombs to take out the ones in the water. That makes sense, like the big groups of them in the water anyway. Okay, yeah, you guys should be able to deal with these guys pretty easily. Or maybe not. Oh. I thought that the last wave was going to be a little bit bigger than that, I'm not going to lie. I thought it was going to be just a tad more huge, you know? But apparently not. There we go, another minigame knocked out. We are moving on to portal combat. Is there going to be some portals involved? Okay, balloon zombies. And it's another conveyor one. Oh. Now this is interesting. And our first thing is a torchwood. Okay. Cherry bomb. So is he gonna go through the portal there as well? I guess probably, right? Start shooting right here. And another cherry bomb. Okay. I'm gonna just wait and see. I feel like this is also going to affect zombies. That would make the most sense. To me, I would say. Okay, you're there. I'm gonna put a cactus right here. Yeah, he can shoot through there and it gets up to that guy. Okay. We can do the same thing with this one, I presume. Yeah, okay. I like where this is going. This is pretty cool. So we basically just want to put our offensive plants in these three rows in the middle. I don't know if putting them on the bottom or top is going to affect it. Like, is it going to go through that portal and come out of this one? I don't know. But I don't want to waste, like, a repeater figuring that out, so... I'm not going to do that, you know? I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to set my guys up. Just going to set my guys up. We are doing looking pretty damn good at the moment. We got a lot of shooters out. A hell of a lot of shooters. Portal relocating. Oh... Interesting. That's really weird. Oh no, that's cool, because it's going through there, and then out of the top one. But this guy's not shooting, I just noticed. Okay then. So I guess it does make sense to set up some stuff on every row. But we got a lot going on here. This guy's just dying. It's insane. I am gonna just start placing guys on every row just in case. You know, just to be safe, I'll do the same thing here, because you never know where it's gonna move to. I guess I'll torch wood right here. Set everything on fire as it goes through. Okay. Cactus on the middle one. Oh yeah, we are doing pretty good right now, I gotta say. I mean, yeah, it's gonna move shortly. Yeah, portal relocating. I'm gonna put a pea shooter there. Which one's moving? Okay, you're both just down there now. That's interesting, but all right. Fair enough. I mean, I feel like that's not super... Oh, well, actually, no. They're all just appearing on the bottom. Oh my god, that's a lot of zombies. Let me just blow you all up. They're all like, okay, yeah, we gotta go through here. And he's gonna shoot it. And it's gonna pop it. Oh my god, this is cool. This is a really, really cool one. I like this a lot. But they are all spawning just on the bottom row now. Because they all know that they've gotta get through here. I'm just gonna cherry bomb. Okay, balloon zombies coming through, but they're already dying. Oh, this is ridiculous. I love it. Well, this guy decided to go up to the top. He decided to be different. We have at least one cactus on every row, so balloon zombies are going to be stomped no matter where they appear. Portal relocating again. What do we got? What are you doing this time? It's over there now. Okay, that... Are they shooting through that then? I don't know if they are. I feel like it's not working, is it? Yeah, no, they're kind of shooting through it. Or maybe they're not. I can't actually tell. It's kind of difficult to tell. I'm just going to blow you guys up. You can go... Oh, actually, we've kind of filled up everything. I don't know if we're going to get any more torchwood, so I'm just going to start putting stuff down. We'll put another walnut here. Pea shooter. You guys are really blocking my conveyor. Yes, I'm trying to figure out, like, this guy's shooting right here. I guess it is coming out of this top one, then. I thought maybe it wasn't going to work like that, but it seems that it does. I might drop it. Oh, now we get another torchwood. We'll dig up this cactus and put a torchwood. Oh, we'll dig up pea shooter, put a torchwood. Okay, and then I'm gonna dig up another cactus right here and put a pea shooter, because I believe that pea shooters are stronger than the cactus. Same thing here, I'll take out this pea shooter, put a repeater. Take out a cactus and put a pea shooter. As long as we have one cactus on every row, we're fine. Oh god, I don't even need this cherry, but I'm gonna do it anyway. That was overkill. That was a lot of fun. I liked that one a lot, but it was overkill. Like, oh my god, that was overkill. It was good though. That was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun with that one. I had a lot of fun with that one. Now, we've got a little bit of time left in the episode. I don't know quite how long these next ones will be. So we are going to go ahead and head over to our Zen garden to end off the episode. We're going to fill these guys with some water. That's a weird way of phrasing it. I don't know why I said it like that at all, to be honest. Wake up, Stinky. Have some chocolate. Start watering. I watered the wrong one there. Okay, you guys, and you, and you. I wish it didn't put the watering can back up in your inventory after every time you water. That's just a little bit annoying. But, you know, whatever. It's not that big of a deal, I guess. God, I'm doing this every single day, and all we're getting out of it is money. Should I even do this? You guys let me know if you even want to see me keep doing the freaking marigolds. Because I feel like we don't need to do that. Also, these guys aren't glowing anymore. Some of them were glowing before, now they're not. I guess they glow when they've been musicked. That seems to be the case. I guess it makes them more proficient at making money? I have no idea. I don't get more proficient. Actually, no, that's not true. When I'm listening to music, I do get more proficient at working. Which, in turn, gets me money. So I guess I get it, marigolds. I guess I get it. All right, here we go. Almost got all of them fully grown. I'm just gonna get this last guy fully grown, and then I'm just kind of gonna stop worrying about them, I think. Because we don't need money. I may or may not have cheated to get maximum money, and you may or may not have forgiven me for that already, right? So, you know, not gonna worry about it. There we go, fully grown, all of our plants. Let's move on over to the Tree of Wisdom. What do you got for us? If you rely on upgrade plants in Survival Endless, be acutely aware that they get more expensive the more you have on your lawn. Interesting. Okay. The imps and eye zombies seem weak, but they're speedy and great for fetching that last braying when you've cleared the rest of the opposition. Okay. I'm sure that'll make more sense when we play that minigame. If you type tricked out, don't be surprised if you see something wacky happen to your lawnmowers. Tricked out. Okay, hang on. New game. Tricked out. Whoa, what is this? I have no idea, but I'm gonna let him hit it and see what happens. Bro, they move a lot slower when you're just waiting for them to move. Or at least it feels like they do. I know in reality they don't. But it feels like they do. Come on, hit that lawnmower. I want to know if anything different happens. Oh, absolutely nothing different. Okay, well, I don't know what I expected, but I expected something, I guess. All right, Tree of Wisdom, give me some more. 50 feet tall, okay. Thank you for feeding me. I am out of new wisdom for now, but I might have more if you grow me tall enough. Oh, okay. I think it's like 50 and then 100 after that is when you get more wisdom or something. I'm unsure, but he's just going to keep going. I'm out of new wisdoms. How are you out of new wisdom? You are a big old tree fella. How are you out? Let me buy some more food for you there, bud. Just a little bit more, you know, I keep missing just a little bit more. Okay, and then I think we also need to buy a rake. There we go. I kind of wish that there was an option to buy, like, multiple rakes or just an infinite rake that never disappears for, like, a certain amount of money or something. Oh yeah, I know about the future thing. I guess it just gives us random wisdom that it's already given us now, whenever we hop in here. Because obviously it's not going to give us anything if we're talking to it, if we're feeding it. It's just going to keep saying, I got no wisdoms. I'm all out of wisdoms. So I'm gonna feed it this last little bit. And then I guess we're kind of done talking to this guy for the time being. I mean, I'll look up at what level or at what feat he gives us some more wisdom, and then we can kind of aim to... Or I'll just do, like, in one episode or something, I'll just go and I'll do it all off camera, and then I'll show you what it looks like or what wisdom he gives us. Anyway, folks, that's gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Plants vs. Zombies. Next time, back into the minigames, Call 'em Like You See 'em, Bobsled Bonanza, and depending on how quick they go, Zombie Nimble Zombie Quick. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.